Alright, hello and welcome. I'm Mara28 and I'm here with a slightly late episode of Bevo's Tech Back. I believe this is episode 29, and for now, this is probably going to be the first episode of heading back to the overworld for a little bit. I had been doing my best to try to go ahead and progress through the Twilight Forest as much as I could, and once I got to the Aurora Tower, Aurora Palace, the Snow Witch's Tower. At least it will be the Snow Witch's Tower. I ran into a dead end. It doesn't really exist yet in this version of... It did not exist in that version of the Twilight Forest. I have taken the opportunity to go ahead and update to the newest version of Bevo's Tech Pack. Actually, I think I might actually be on the beta version of the newest one. So, I mean, I went from being behind to being ahead. So, all fun stuff. And what are these guys doing here? I have no idea. Anyway, so we're now ahead in versions, which is good. But in that, some things have changed. Number one, there is no longer... blue power is gone. And since blue power is gone, I no longer have an easy way to make the brass alloys I was using for flax spirits. Plus, for some reason, my armor now renders... It doesn't render the plates, which is unfortunate. And just a combination of things, I still want to go ahead and finish up that village that I'm building, but I want to concentrate on building the village, not necessarily harvesting the resources to build the village. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to actually use my technology in the main world to actually build up the stuff I need to build the fantasy world. I know it's kind of odd, but it's I'd rather spend time doing that than to manually farming, because that is very tedious. Where are you coming from? There are no slime islands here. I mean, where are you spawning? None. Well, okay. Options. No. Help. Regenerate. Alright, we'll see if that shows anything new on the, Yeah, no, there's no freaking... I don't know. I'm getting away from these slimes. They're going to drive me nuts. Slime squishing is one of those things that I just don't like hearing after an extended period of time. Alright, so we still have like a ton of pearls and stuff. We could stay out here and we could be fine. But at this point, without having a clear route of progress, without making a really ugly Twilight Forest because of the changes to biome generation, there are now more biomes, so things aren't going to quite work out right. What I'm going to do is I'm going to call the epic of the monster hunting to an end after the death of the Yeti. We still need to finish up our Twilight Village, which we will do, but it's not going to be done now. For now, we're going to head back to the overworld. We're going to see some of the things that have changed, because I've skipped three versions now, and I've missed a lot of changes, and I need to catch back up. And, well, is there anything else here that we either need to take with us or go away? You're ruining things. Go away. Or sit there. Fine. You can sit there. All right. No, I think we're good. I think we're ready to go home. I have everything I really need. Everything else can stay here. Oh. You know, I know. Let's take these guys. Alright. We have Lich, Hydra, Naga, and Argast. Excellent. Alright, so way home. We just go upstairs and shift. That never gets old. Zoom. Alright. So we can see my much maligned tower. I still have not finished it. It's a very long list of things that I still need to finish. One of the things that's going to be done first up, though, is I might need to work on improving my power system here. With the time I set it up, I had been using these TNT generators because, for the most part, they were very easy to use. Fairly easy to use. They worked well, and I did get excess power with them. I mean, I've still got a full capacitor. Everything's been running here on autopilot fairly well. Alright. I mean, it's making a good amount of power, right? It is a little bit laggy, though. I mean, it's there's probably better options, and I might be... it might be a good idea for me to look into them. Oh, wow, you're totally full. Holy cow. You know what? Let's go check the nether real quick. Nether's this way. For that drum to be full of XP means that my wither killer has been running the entire time. What do you mean I just need to go deeper? I've been deeper. So this entire time and I have 39 wither skulls. Oh, that's sad. I would have thought I would have had more. Oh well, that works. And back we go. It's a very noisy system, but it works. Alright, let's just go ahead and go downstairs. So let's take a quick gander at the mod list here. I gotta replace that armor, that's it's no bueno. Alright, so some new stuff that we may not have had before. First off, this is a new version of Buildcraft. I believe this uses redstone flux now, which is good. It makes it a little bit easier to get things together without having to go through the hassle of trying to set up different power networks. And I know some people aren't necessarily happy about that, but for the most part, the entire MJ system was a hassle. I understand why they made some of the choices they did. It just didn't, however, really add anything to the experience. Alright, okay, so big reactors is in here now. That's a really big change. It's pretty nice. When I updated, I think I left in... where is it? Oh. See, enhanced portals is now part of the pack. That's good. Let's see, we've had all of this stuff so far. Okay, I don't remember what... I don't remember garden containers, that looks to be no. We've had Growthcraft. So far, this is just those three. Oh, nice. Malice's Doors. I don't recall that getting added, but this is actually a really awesome mod. I've been playing with it in a single-player world I've been working on. You can make some quite awesome things with this. Plus, you can... No, you know what? I tell you what. We'll actually play with this a little bit later today. That is a very, very fun mod. Let's see. And that's really pretty much it. Oh yeah, random things is now part of the pack. I went ahead and just let it go through this time just because it's... I got tired of it asking me. So I said, okay. Oh yes. Steve's workshop and storage drawers are also here. Spice of Life now is a lunch bag? Lunchbox, lunch bag. I have to find out what those do. And the rest of it's just really a lot of updates. Oh, and, yeah, workbook. I think we had that. Yeah, we did. Alright. Oh, my. Yeah, I gotta do something about that. Something around here is officially, kicked into 11 and my computer screaming. Alright, welcome back. In the effort of not destroying everything like I had been doing with the Paxel, I'm keeping the monosteel pick just because it works great for me. We are, however, back to using the reinforced jetpack and the free runners because, let's face it, these things are dynamite. In terms of flight and mobility, they do beat what the exosuit offered, even though the exosuit jumping was extremely fun. So what we're doing right now, let's go ahead and open this up, and can I paste into here? No, that would have been too easy. See, mod.malices, I think, doors. Fantastic, there we go. So this has a wide variety of stuff. It's got, basically you can make your own doors, plus there are already some existing doors that you can do some fun stuff with. The Shoji Shoji. I can't pronounce that. I'm going to butcher it. This door is pretty nice. It's a wooden sliding door. It matches the thing we have up on the roof. The vanishing frames are just what they sound like. You apply a redstone signal, and then whatever it is, it vanishes. Let's see if we can go ahead and get the recipe for that. So it's ender pearl sticks and redstone. So, I mean, that's easy, right? Let's make 8 of those. Let's also get a lever. And we need something to decorate these things with. Bleached bone bricks will take you. So, for example, these behave just like carbon blocks. You go ahead and cover it up. And then you have this little barrier here. Let's make one more. And then you have a wall here, right? The only problem is if you notice these every now and then, they fidget. I don't know why they do it, but they do. Anyway, if we go ahead and then apply a redstone signal, they just vanish. It's pretty awesome. I just wish that the did not occasionally get the fidgets. It's not going to do it now, is it? Alright, so the things that I really like that are in here are the this thing right here is a door factory. Basically, it lets you make whatever door you would like to use. I don't think I have iron doors in here, actually. So there's that. Do I have any pistons? I do now. There we go, door factory. And we'll go ahead and put this guy right over... Let's say... Skystone brick. Is that actually a brick or is that a facade? Yeah, we'll put it there for now. Alright, so we have this thing here. Using this, you're able to make your own doors based on whatever blocks you have. So you can define the movement of it. It can slide up and down. It can be a vault door. It can rotate. Slides up. Bunch of different stuff. The sliding four ways is pretty neat. You can tell how long it takes. You can make it require redstone. You can tell if it's a double door. And you can even assign it sounds. And for the actual door frame itself, you can tell what the outline is. Like, say, if I wanted to use this bleached bone, that would make the overall outline of the door made out of that. And then the top block material on the bottom block would determine what would be inside of it for the top and bottom half. Usually, you might want to match it, though. You could get creative mixing things together. Let's see, what do we have in here? I don't think any of the spiral open doors will work quite right in a 3x3 area. Let's see, that's going to be stone brick, though. Do we have any of that in here? We do. Actually, I gotta be honest, I really didn't expect to see this in here. This is actually, I'm really happy it is here, though. We have garage doors, too. I don't think we can decorate those, though. The heck is a production table? Oh, and the block mixer is also really neat. Okay. So we're going to come over here. We are going to go ahead and put the frame type as stone brick, and then top and bottom as stone brick, too. Okay, we're going to make a door that is a rotating four ways, double door, and we're going to tell build. Oh, we need to specify sound. Let's go for pneumatic. Build and build. Materials. There we go. And these do stack because they are the same thing. So we're going to pretend this is going to fit right, even though it does not fit right. We'll put it down. So we have these doors. They do stand out. You can tell that they're just not a regular seamless wall. They have the little indention and stuff. So, as far as I know, there's no way around it, but the door does that. How awesome is that? It is a little loud, and it is a, I don't normally build 2x2 doorways. This, though, the ability to make stuff like this makes me kind of want to do that, because this is neat. And then you just walk right in. I gotta say, I really do like that. Alright, hello and welcome back. I thought that'd be a quick little stopover. It wasn't. We're now here the next day, and I've made some progress setting up for what I want to do here. This is just a really simple little bare-bones room. And I had forgotten about the Wrath lamps from Factorization. These are the magic lamps. They're the same thing. And boy, do I love these things. They're fantastic. The four of them is filling up this room. I could probably get away with having one in the center. I just didn't want to do it. Because, I mean, if you compare how bright that room is, compare it to how bright this room is, yeah. These things are fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. So what we're doing here, we are going to be setting up a big reactor. I'm going to have one. It's going to be roughly 7 by 7 by 7, I think. And it's going to be sunk into the floor. For the resources that I have right now, if you can see this little sad little tank here, this is all of the cryothium I have. That's not enough for a regular full reactor, so we're going to be mixing some materials together. And this may or may not work. If it doesn't work, oh well. The big trick is going to be to see if I can get past the amount of power that I get out of the TNT generators, which is going to be approximately, let's see, they're 640 apiece. So as long as I can get 1280 out of it, we should be fine. Worst case scenario, I'll just tweak it around a bit, try to find a better layout. So first things first, though, let's go ahead and clear out a spot here. All right, here we go. So what I do need to make is I need to make some reactor casings. I should have everything in here that I need to go, though, so that should be a good... It takes a lot of steel, of graphite, and of eulorium. And if I did my basic math right, I'm going to need a lot. All right. You know, let's just go for that for now. Let's get the wand. So this is 7x7, right? Okay, so we need to build around here as well. And there's no point having the glass actually outside of the bottom here, so it's this is all going to be the solid casing. Alright, and let's get a little bit of builder wand action going on, because it is one of the most fantastic items ever. Bam. Alright, and these I'll have to place manually. Probably gonna have monsters spawning next to my reactor. That's gonna be fantastic. Oops. Okay, stop this. Use wand. Oh, I'm walking into the frickin'. Okay. So we got that. Let's just go across. Let's move the torch. Right there's fine. Alright, so that's good, and then we just need to fill in the bottom. Alright, so that is the bottom part of a reactor. This is, let's see, that's 3, so it's going to go 3 up. Why won't you place? Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's the top right there. Yeah, I think this is a good size. That's definitely a good size, and I definitely made too many of the reactor casings. That's okay. I think I can use this stuff to make the glass. Alright, so we have this in here. What I'm going to use... Let's go ahead and make the fuel rods. Given the amount of resources I currently have and slash don't have, for the outer casing, I know a lot of people, well, outer casing, for the outer material, I know a lot of people like using Resonant Ender. I don't have the shiny metal to do that, since I started this world before thermal expansion was added in. That means I have very little Invar, which means I have very little shiny, which means very little. Yeah. What I'm going to be using are the graphene blocks out of big reactors itself, because they're actually pretty good. They're not great, but for what they cost to make, I mean, these are basically trees that have been cooked 3 times, so they're cheap. And for what they are, they're pretty good. Alright, so we'll make some fuel rods. Alright, so we have 6 columns here. I think I might just do a regular cross 5. It's not going to be quite right. Though, what I was actually thinking of, let's just go for the 8. We'll see how well this works, or how terrible this works. I ran out of graphene. Fantastic. Let's see. Okay. Let's get up here. Get down. Thank you. Down. Because I think I could turn some of these blocks I have back into ingots and I will be okay. No, actually, that's completely it. Alright, so do I have any graphene blocks in here? How about charcoal? I do have charcoal, so that's good. Luckily, I happen to know where there is a quickly located induction furnace. Oh, that has a stack of graphite that I'm missing. Fantastic. Oh, I hate hover mode and stairs. Alright, so we're going back down. Let's get these back in here. Back in here. Alright, so I just need 4 more. Okay, that's it. Now, this is probably going to run really hot. If it does, that's okay. It's just going to be really, really freaking hot. The other option that I could do is I could go for a little standard cross shape one, which I think might work well. Cross X, whatever. Basically, because if I run it like this, right, when these fuel rods are actually full and they have the ellurium in it, radiation's going to go north, east, southwest, right? So anything in the center here, it's not going to get further triggered by the outer rods, and it's not going to trigger anything else. So it's not going to be too useful for what I want to do. If I wanted, I could have it set up so that the entire outer range here was full up of the fuel rods, and then they would continually trigger each other. So this one right here would end up being triggered by the 2 this way, as well as the 2 this way. And the one in the center here would be triggered by the ones immediately next to it and the one across from it. So it's going to be triggered a lot more. It will run a lot hotter, I believe. But I don't know if it's actually worth the additional cost and fuel. No, we're gonna do it. I don't care. All right, and I have to do the last one manually because this is now going to derp out. All right, and we have our wrench, right? Good. Okay, let's go ahead and get a bucket. I don't know why I have 15 buckets. Yeah, barely enough. Alright, so luckily cryothium falls, so I could just take a bucket, put it in here. There it goes. And we'll just wait for it to get to the bottom, and as soon as it gets down there, we'll go ahead and drop the next one in. Fairly easy. God, I hope I'm not making, like, the world's worst reactor right now. The other option I had was I have a surplus of Electrum I could have used. We'll find out. I mean, if I need to, I will take out some fuel rods. Okay, so that's good. See, there's really no reason to have any of the reactor glass on here because you can't see anything. But it's, I kind of like the way the graphite blocks look. Alright, so I do need to make some control rods. I need to make 8 of them, actually. Okay, which means I need to get these guys in there. I'm going to need a lot more than that. Come here and grab the graphite. I wish this saved the, no, control rod, not fuel rod. One, two, three, four, five. Alright, so I need some more of the casing. Alright, so that is all of the actual control rods I need. Just go right up top here. These go on top of the fuel rods. And I think what I'll do is I will have a reactor glass up top here so that I can see into it. This stuff, though, I could just use blocks. And I need a 16. Reactor. Alright, so this should get the top. Fantastic. And now the ones I have in here already, let's make a little bit more. I believe you combine with glass, two glass blocks to get reactor glass. Okay. There we go. So now there's no falling into the stuff that's worse than lava. Alright, so this just means that I now have the sides here, which are going to be 10 blocks a face, right? Yeah, 10 blocks. So I've got 40 casings that I need to fill, and inside of that I need to have a reactor controller. There we go. More casings. You know, I think I can just get away just making the 40 of them. There we go. Okay, reactor controller. I need a power tap. I need to make more casing. Okay, power tap. Reactor item. Where is it? Oh, I probably should say this. This is a passively cooled reactor, no turbine. We need access ports. So we got two of those, that's good. Reactor redstone port. I don't think I need that right now, but I tell you what, we're going to make that. We're going to leave a spot for it, and we're also going to leave a spot for a computer port. All right. So that's good. And then I need more reactor casings. I purposely made sure that I had more than enough iron and steel, well, steel and graphite before starting this, and I still ran out of graphite. I'm amazed my iron supply held up. Okay, so when we come in here, the main thing you see is you come down here, and either this side here or this side here is going to be the front. Considering I have access to my ME system on this wall, I'm inclined to make it this side for the access for the for the controller. Though having it come in this way, no, this way is better. Stop that. The power tap, though, the power tap we will do on the back because we don't need to look at that. And if needed, I can expand to get another power tap. Okay, the access ports. The access ports I can actually hide below level, but for now we'll put them over here. Let's put them here and here. We will go ahead, snowball. So turn that to the item outlet. Ejects waste contained in the reactor, place an ingots in the reactor's access ports. Okay. It's not going to do anything until I finish building it, is it? Alright. Let's go ahead and make a little bit of reactor glass. Oh, that's more than I wanted to make. Alright, so for around this, I do want the glass, just because I think that looks awesome. However, for these sides, it really won't matter, because I'm not going to be looking at it. Alright, and we'll just do glass around here, too. And it looks like by process of elimination, the side has to have glass. what we can do, though, is balance it out a little bit better. Do you want to do that dead center? Yeah, may as well. You know what I did not put on here is I did not put a freaking, Tile BR metal name. What do you mean? That should be valid. Or am I working off of a newer version? Tile big reactors metal dot name is not valid for the reactor's interior. You should be valid. You poopy face. Alright, let me just get a little bit of Yolorium if we have any left. Oh yeah, we got some. We'll see if this does anything. Yeah, this is... Okay, we passed the TNT machine. It's running a bit hot, though. If it stabilizes at 4, around 4 or 420, I think I'm good with that. This is, not bad, actually. I think I like this. This is pretty good. I wonder why it's saying that it's not valid when I do that, even though it's clearly working. Craziness. It's craziness, I tell you. Now, the unfortunate part is I need to stop this before I waste anything, because I need to actually change out and put this computer control in here somewhere. Right here looks fantastic. It's got the little IO thing. And reactor redstone. We'll do the, actually, you know what, let's move this, move that, move this. Redstone, computer port, and I don't have any other one, so congratulations, you just got promoted to glass. So I can set it so that redstone will toggle it on and off, or change the control rods, eject waste, all that stuff. There's a lot of stuff you can do with the automation on this, but it's a little bit, doing it with just the redstone ports can be maddening. You're better off using the, what is it called? The rednet port. Since you can get you can get 16 different things over one line, it makes it a lot easier. Or if you want to go full hog, you can use the, computer port. Give it a right click, and let's get this thing going again. So this should go back up to around 2,400 redstone flux per tick. Which is, I will accept that. I mean, the millibuckets per tick is 0.065, so that's not... You know, I'd love to tell you that's not bad. I actually don't have any idea how good or bad that is. I need to look that up. The main thing for now, though, is that this is using uranium, which I have a ton of. It is quieter than the TNT generators, and it... I want to say it works better. I don't know for sure, but I want to say that it does. I do, however, need to go ahead and start getting some better cabling and stuff. The Ender IO conduit that I have been using has a hard limit of, I believe, 1,000 redstone flux per tick. Let's see what we got here. No, 640. It got lowered. So this stuff is of no use for me. Actually, it's max output. I might be able to get more than enough if I have multiple inputs. That's worth testing. However, I really don't want to do that. It would probably be in my better interest to go ahead and just get a higher tier conduit. I mean, the enhanced ones aren't that terrible to make. They take the energetic alloys, which is the... Where did it go? It's just redstone, gold, and glowstone, which I have a bunch of right now. So, I mean, there's no reason not to go for that route. If I do that, though, I need to basically tear out everything, and I'm not quite that adventurous yet. Let's get some more uranium. Excuse me, yellorium. There we go. No, you don't have anything. See, this is odd. This outer case didn't update, but this is clearly working, so I'm not quite sure what's up with that. That casing. Okay, it's the energy heat in this. This is holding pretty steady. Holy cow, 6.6? Stop. I might need to put some basic automation on this so that it only turns on if it's below like 80% power, because that's a crazy amount. Alright. This is probably going to do it for today. I know it's kind of a bit of a clunky episode, but I need to do a lot more preparations and stuff. I just need to do a lot of busy work now that we're back in the overworld, and hopefully now that we're back to playing with some more tech stuff. We're not finished with the Twilight Forest. I will be going back there to work on some of the village and stuff yet. I just need to catch back up with everything that I missed between updates, because it has been a while, and this is new and this is fun. Well, it's new to me. It's not necessarily new anymore. I was that far behind. I want to go ahead and thank you for watching this episode of Bevo's Tech Pack. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave a message in the comments below. And as always, have a good day.